It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Shock the system.
Vibe Club.
Vibe Club.
Let me hit you with a scenario. Let me hit you with a scenario that is probably plaguing most Americans right now. Imagine that you're off work. Imagine that it's 6 o'clock. Imagine that it's 6 o'clock on the East Coast because that's important for some reason. Imagine that you're driving and you're wondering, what can I do? I have an hour drive. What can I do for this next hour? Or you're working out and you're like, what can I listen to for this next hour? What can I do to pass this time? Is there anyone out there that I can turn to that can help me out with this dilemma that is plaguing my life on a daily basis, mainly Monday through Friday? Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., I have no idea what I'm going to do with my time. And then a light bulb goes off. Ding! You're thinking, wait a minute. I remember listening to a show. I remember a young whippersnapper. I remember a guy with a bunch of moxie. I remember a guy that had a bunch of go-getting attitude about him that I liked. But where was it? I know where it was. I know who it was. It was that kid, Khalil Creed, and he was doing the Mix at 6, where he brought me the top 6 hip-hop hits in the nation. In the nation. And in between the songs, he gave me a bunch of his random nonsense. He gave me a bunch of entertainment, and all he wanted to do was make me smile with his positivity. Because what he did was, he cultivated a palace of positivity, and he calls it Vibe Club. He calls it Vibe Club. It's just positive energy. It's just positive people. It's just people with the same thoughts and people with different thoughts coming together as one. And it's okay there. It's okay. It's stress-free because he got it. It's stress-free because my ideas and my thoughts and my opinions matter. They matter. And if he doesn't agree with it, it's okay. Because we agree to disagree and we move on. That's right. And you would be correct. That hypothetical person and that hypothetical scenario is correct. I am Khalil Creed. This is The Mix at 6. We are here at the Palace of Positivity, known as Vibe Club, under the umbrella of The Mix 88.9 for another hour of me. Of me and these hits. Of me and these opinions, of me and this entertainment. Because my only goal is to make you smile. Make you smile, make you less stressed, maybe get a giggle out of you. Who knows? Who knows? And so far, I've had a fantastic day, and I hope you've had a fantastic day as well. And if you're listening to my voice, that means you're 40% done with your week, because I'm big on numbers. Men lie, women lie, numbers don't. You're 40% done with your week, as the great poet Jay-Z once said. Except for that last part about being done with the week. He's at the... You get it. You get it. You get it. There's no need to backtrack or start mumbling. But today has been a fantastic day for me. It's been a stress-free day for me. Tuesdays and Thursdays are my downshift during the week. Sunday is the day I try not to do nothing except hang out with the kids. try to take the kids somewhere, try to take the kids out, do something, because during the week I am crazy busy and I see them, you know, here and there, coming and going, but Sunday is a day that I dedicate to them. We find something to go do, but I try to get with them throughout the week, you know, check in with them, make sure, you know, things are good at school. They all got their interims. They're all A, B, and C students, and they are working hard at school, and I am proud of them. I am super proud of them because they could be worse. They could be a whole lot worse, but they're not. They're good kids trying to do good things, and they make their daddy proud. But Mondays and Wednesdays are my slam days. Mondays and Wednesdays are the days that I am the most busy because, as you know, I am a proud cheer and gymnastics dad. I am a proud girl dad on top of having a son that looks just like me and makes me think that cloning is real. I know cloning is real. Don't at me. Don't come at me. But on Mondays and Wednesdays, my oldest daughter has her cheer practice where us parents have been banned. They closed the practice because they don't know how to act during the practice. But it's still the days that I go and I sit outside and I wait for her. It's like I'm her personal chauffeur. I'm a personal chauffeur and I drive her around to her appointments and, you know, Mondays and Wednesdays are the days that I spend the most time with them on top of Sundays because they do have practice. My youngest daughter and son, all three of them have practice on Wednesday. But I felt some type of way yesterday after practice. I went and picked my daughter up from cheer practice. And I walk in and she comes up to me and she says, "Daddy, can I have some money to get a bottle of water?" I was like, "Sure." I said, "But it's a water fountain over there." She was like, "I know. I had to drink fountain water during practice." And I looked at her. "So you had to do what?" She said, "I had to drink fountain water during practice." You poor baby. You mistreated child. How dare you have to drink some fountain water? Water out of the water fountain. It's called a water fountain for a reason. You had to drink out of the water fountain. See, these kids don't know. These kids don't know, and y'all not gonna get my blood pressure up today. Y'all not gonna get me yelling and ranting, but y'all kids don't know. Y'all don't know about having to drink out of the hose. Y'all don't know about not being allowed to come back inside. Y'all don't know about hearing y'all ain't gonna keep running in and out of this house. Y'all not going back and forth. That's the first time I heard the term back and forth. Y'all not gonna be running back and forth. Either you're gonna be in or you're gonna be out. Y'all don't know nothing about getting kicked out of the house and having to be gone all day, because if you come back in the house, you watching Young and the Restless. You watching as the world turns. You sitting on the couch and you're going to be quiet and you're going to wait until, you know, you have the opportunity to go back outside again. But y'all know nothing about that. Y'all know nothing about being trapped in the house watching Jeopardy. Y'all know nothing about that. Y'all don't know nothing about that life. All y'all know is what we've provided for y'all, which is this sheltered dome, a shell of what we grew up with. I don't know. I just felt some type of way when she said I had to drink. And she said it with disgust. I had to drink fountain water. As though, and so what you saying? So what you saying? Say what you gonna say. So what you saying? But of course, I caved in and gave it $1 to go get her a bottle of water because we don't want Miss Bougie having to drink fountain water. So she got a bottle of water and saved her life, apparently. But that's what I'm dealing with. And she's 10. So it's only going to get worse. It's going to get worse. It's going to get more expensive than $1. So I got to nip it in the bud at some point in time. But I'll do anything for my girls. I'll do anything for my kids. I'll do anything for my son. I'll do anything for them. So we'll see. I'm creating my own monster. And I'm going to have to slay that monster here pretty soon, because she's already getting an attitude and starting to feel herself and, you know, getting an attitude. And I can only imagine, you know, when she start going through her changes, how that's going to be. But we'll see. I still have hope. I am excited about this weekend because we are traveling to North Carolina for her first competition that counts. Her first competition that they can place in. Her first competition where they gonna show everybody what they got. These girls that are on this team, the Shell Shockers over at Dynamic Gymnastics, they have never cheered before. Not cheered together before, but done competitive cheerleading at all. None of them have done it at all. So to see where they came from in the beginning, to see where they're at now, it's amazing. It's amazing, and I am so proud of her for sticking with it. I'm so proud of her for toughing through it, because she needed some toughening up, but she stuck with it. She loves it. It's a good time. I bought her all the backpacks and the bows and the uniforms, the practice and the competition and the makeup and the jerseys and the shirts, and I just got everything she wanted. Everything she wanted. So I'm excited about this weekend. We'll be out of town, leaving on Friday, coming back on Sunday. So it's gonna be a good weekend with me and her. And I can't stop talking about how proud I am of my baby, because she worked hard. They worked hard. All them girls there worked hard, and it showed. It showed during the showcase, and I have no doubt that it's gonna show down in North Carolina this weekend. She is extremely nervous, but she's not as nervous as me, and she is the one that is performing. But I told her that nervousness is a good thing. Nervousness is what keeps you fresh. It's what keeps you on your toes. When you're not nervous about something, that's when there's an issue. I'm nervous every day when I come on this radio. I am nervous every day before I hit this record button. I get a small dose of anxiety before I hit record, because I don't want to mess up. I don't want to disappoint you all. But I come on here, and once I hit that button, I go into performance mode. And you get the full creed. You get the full creed, and that's what you deserve. But let's go ahead and get into some entertainment news and talk about other people's problems, because I love being nosy and I love hearing about other people going through it. So apparently Lil Wayne's under investigation. Lil Wayne apparently, well, this is what the guy said. There was a party at Lil Wayne's house. Lil Wayne got into it with this security guy. This is the guy that actually made the report. He got into it with Lil Wayne. I guess they got into a fight. I don't know if they got into a fight or it was just a big argument, but either way, Lil Wayne told him to leave. So he was leaving, and on the way out, he stopped to go to the bathroom. When he came out of the bathroom, I guess he ran to Lil Wayne again. They got into it again, and allegedly, Lil Wayne pulled out an AR-15 on him. Now, nobody got shot, nobody got hurt, nothing of that sort went down. But it is worth noting that I don't think Lil Wayne is supposed to be around guns or have guns or be in the vicinity of guns or any of that, because of past legal issues or past legal woes that prevent him from having any kind of firearms. But his people, his representatives, have said that it is untrue that Lil Wayne did not have a gun. He does not have a gun. And that those claims are completely false. So somebody in line. So it's either one way or the other. Either the bodyguard just made up a completely fabricated story, or Lil Wayne is lying about not having a gun. I don't know. I won't dare. But it is kind of funny that the guy who called the police didn't press charges. Because why would you call the police and do this report and go all, you know, about this way if you weren't pressing charges, because you felt that you were in danger of, you know, at some point in time? But he says he's not pressing charges, so it is what it is. It's not my call to do. But it would be entertaining to see a giant security guard wrestle with Lil Wayne, as you know, he is little, like he says he is. He's not a big guy, so to see that confrontation would be highly entertaining. But nobody just fights anymore. Nobody does that anymore, because people can't fight these days. People want to shoot. People want to pull out guns. People want to, you know, be extra. But not saying that that's what Lil Wayne did, but that's just what the climate is, you know, these days. And, you know, Lil Wayne is from where, you know, back when I grew up. So, I don't know. I'm sure more will come out about it. And if I hear more, you're going to hear more, because that's what I do here. And something else that I do here is I give you the top six hip hop hits in the nation. I give you the music to make you feel good inside. And coming in at number six is a new addition to the Mix at Six. It is making its debut. It is Blast and Ty Dolla $ign featuring Tyga. And this is Chosen here on the Mix at Six on the Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip hop countdown.
Yo. Number six.
Hey, when it come to you, pistol like buzz, issue with trust. Won't let no one get a piece of your love. Yeah, base it on loyalty, base it on us. I ain't the picture perfect type, but I'm making it up. You say you want a bad flip, but I can't get enough. I'm rich and lumber, when I'm with you, I'm bitter as. Forbidden fruit on apple juice, can I sip on the cup? Mix it with some 1942 and I'm beating you up. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
Girl, you chosen. Sign this NDA, no, you can't bring no phones in. We walk in and they're like, what's all the commotion? No, he can't step a foot in here if we don't know him. Treat you special, girl, I hit you with the roses. Can't stand your boyfriend, he's too controlling. You get along better with me. Get up when you bust wide open.
Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
Yeah, I f*** with her. Yeah, brand new Rollie got you frozen. Two more shots, got that pussy wide open. Said she wanna go another round, don't provoke him. Shorty up and down on the pole like she voting. I like when you talk that to me. This ain't nothing new, but you know how to do it to me. Turn the face down, we can make a little movie. I'm the rapper, you the groupie, got it wetter than jacuzzi. She love me like Lucy. I'm a dog like Snoopy. Getting head in the sheets and you sweating out your weave. Rich, I ain't cheap when I like what I see.
Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
You're listening to the Mix at 6 here on the Mix 88.9. That was our number 6 song, Blast and Ty Dolla $ign featuring Tyga, Chosen. And moving right along into our number 5 song, here is Silk Sonic, Leave the Door Open.
Give me the hip hop countdown.
Yo. Number 5.
You're coming through.
You are listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 5 song, Silk Sonic, Leave the Door Open. That song is really hanging in there, along with the Doja Cat songs, but this song has really, it won't leave my life. It will not leave this top 6, and I know there are those of you who feel the same way, but it's still here. It's hanging in there. People love it. And as long as they love it, then I'ma keep playing it. But moving on, Jasmine Sullivan did a super dope thing. She apologized to some of her fans. She didn't have to, but she felt it was the right thing to do. Some fans were unable to buy tickets to her upcoming tour. The reason they weren't able to buy tickets to the upcoming tour is because resellers were buying them. Resellers were buying them and then jacking the prices up. As a matter of fact, she was only selling her tickets for $40. And the resellers were buying all the tickets and reselling them for $200. And she felt that was unfair to her fans and her fan base and the people she is trying to reach and the people that have supported her up until now. So she canceled some of her shows. I don't know if she canceled the whole tour or if she just canceled certain shows. But she did issue an apology about it, saying that this was not the intent and this is not, when you see those high prices, that's not her doing. She put her fans over profit, and I think that that's super dope. I think that's super dope of her. She seems like a super dope individual because, you know, she could have just as well just ignored the issue, but she saw something that was wrong, that was being done, that was wrong, that she felt was wrong, and she addressed it and she did what she felt was right. So I thought that that was super dope and I salute her for that. Shame on you resellers. Shame on you resellers for preying on us innocent people. It's the very reason that I don't have a PlayStation 5. And I don't have a PlayStation 5 is because whenever they're released, scalpers, well, I don't know if they're scalpers, but they resellers come in and buy them. They jack the prices up. I'm not paying $1,000 for a PlayStation 5. I'm not going to do it. I'm not paying $900 for a PlayStation 5. I'm not going to do it. I am just not going to do it. I am going to wait. I am going to rely on the fact that I will get one when I'm supposed to get one. It seems that all of my friends are getting them and I'm getting a little jealous. I'm happy for them, but I'm getting a little jealous. Brent was the first one to get one that I know of. The first person that I knew to get a PlayStation 5 was Brent, but he got one when they first dropped. I don't know how he did it. We all signed up for the notifications when they were on sale, but he got one. I don't know, but you know, I'm not jealous. I'm not jealous at all, but he got one and I went down to Florida to visit him and Tori and I seen it in person and that made me want one even more. The controllers are dope. The feel of it, like it's not the, I didn't like feel this PlayStation 5. That'd be weird. I meant the controllers. The controllers compared to the PlayStation 4 controllers, they're smoother. I like the look of them. They look more futuristic. So it made me want one even more. And I haven't gotten one yet. And I'm not going to not keep bringing that up and not fighting a good fight. But I'm not going to pay $1,000 for one. I refuse to do it. So I once again have signed up. A couple of more of my friends have gotten one. Jake and Brandon have both gotten one. And they're a couple and they live together and they both got a PlayStation 5. So they have two PlayStation 5s in their one house and I can't get one PlayStation 5 in my one house. That's not fair. That's not fair to me. It's not fair to Creed. We have to be fair to Creed and it's not fair to me. I'm not jealous. I promise you I'm not jealous. I'm happy for them. I truly am happy for Brent, for Brandon, for Jake, for getting one. I'm happy for them, but I want one and I'm gonna get one, but I'm not gonna pay $1,000 for it. I'm not gonna pay the upselled price for it because it's not right. It's not right. It's not cool to take advantage of people and I'm not gonna feed into it. So I believe and I'm gonna continue to believe that I will get one when I'm supposed to get one. Rant over, getting off my soapbox. Megan Good was on The God's Honest Truth with Charlamagne Tha God. That comes on Paramount Plus. And, you know I'm a fan of his. I have his books also that I've read. And she talked about possibly becoming a gun owner. Here's what she had to say.
We've been talking about guns in the Second Amendment, and you're from California, right?
Yeah.
And there's been a lot of home invasions. Do you think you need a gun?
You know what's crazy is for a long time I felt like I didn't, but now with everything that's going on, I would feel more comfortable with a gun.
Really?
The reason before, my thought was like, if something did happen to me, would I have the time to pull out a gun to defend myself? But I think with like the home invasions and everything, if someone breaks into my house and I have time to grab my gun, I don't want to kill anybody or hurt anybody, but I will defend myself.
Now, me personally, I was against, well, I wasn't against it. I just didn't look at myself as the person that needed to own a gun. But times have changed. Like the world's climate has changed and people have shown who they really are and how dangerous they can be and the extremes that people will go to achieve what they want. And the last thing I want is for my family to be at risk. I don't think that, you know, being the size I am and the training that I do have, that I necessarily need a gun, but that is not going to stop someone else from seeing that as well and going above and beyond to try to cause harm. Now, I'm not saying I'm going out and buying a gun. I'm not saying that I have a bunch of guns. I'm not saying I don't have a bunch of guns either. So you just never know. Just don't run up in my house. That's all I'm saying. I'm just saying that my family will be protected. My children will be protected. My safe space will be protected. Our safe space will be protected by any means necessary. So, you know, I support anyone who has guns for that purpose. I support anyone who is taking the steps necessary to make sure that their people are safe and their family is safe and their space is safe, because no one should have to worry about someone invading their space. You know, your home and where your children are, that should be a place where you're comfortable, where you can be stress free, where you can relax, you can let your guard down. It's not somewhere that I feel you need to be on guard or have to worry about, you know, protecting. But times have changed. Times have definitely changed. So if you decide to be a registered gun owner, you know, I'm definitely not against it. I definitely see why. I definitely understand why. I definitely support your decision and, you know, and what you do. And, you know, like I said, I'm not giving away the secrets of whether I am or am not a gun owner or am not, you know, someone who thinks that's necessary. Well, I do think it's necessary to protect your family, but just don't run in my house. That's all I'm saying. You know, it's our safe space. Don't run in nobody's house, not just mine. Don't run in nobody's house. It's their safe space. Don't be an a-hole. Like, leave people alone. Don't make people have to defend themselves at their house. But if you do, more power to you. But let's get back into this countdown. Let's get into this number 4 song. Here is Drake featuring Lil Baby, Girls Want Girls, here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop countdown. Yeah.
Number 4.
Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking out that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, look, yeah, girls want girls where, hey, look, yeah. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, hey, girls want girls where, hey, what? Girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, can I play a player, baby? I grew up with Dreya face. I done seen the realest ones come and leave a crazy way. Had to take my spot, it wasn't something they just gave away. Sorry to all my fans, they might have called me on a crazy day. Thinking trying to block me on a fadeaway. I've been on a downy vibe with a payday. Say you go that way, I guess we both go the same way. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, yeah, where we both from. Hey, and you just got to Miami, need hotel rooms. Told you that they love you, but they fell through. So you shot in 42, cause you, ayy. Then you throwing on that dress, cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking out of that you done been through. Yeah, texting me and say I need to see you. I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. I might come, I might talking all the that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from, yeah. But girls want girls where I'm from, yeah. Girls want girls where I'm from, yeah. Girls want girls. Hey, yeah, girls want girls where I'm
my
from.
My girl got a girlfriend. Ain't tryna be out of shape. What's the up on them curls? Then them gym don't work, get surgery. I'll pay for that, my courtesy. Can't imagine no curving me. I put in that work overly. I handle business, and I got two pretty. Keep them up on fleek. They got matching Benz and matching AP. Now they can really call each other twins. I'm cool with all the owners, they love me. So they gon' let us in and bring all of your peers and look better with more people. We got 1942 Casamigos, it's getting heated. They gotta follow us in the Uber, my car filled up with shooters. It be lights, camera, action when you with us, it's a movie. I don't try my coupe to house parties, I'm tryna leave with two of them. Shh, yeah. Don't nobody know that we do. She like you, I'm like me too. I can't wait to get out work to go and see you. Please bring your girlfriend along with you. Y'all been on my mind too much, like what the f- is wrong with me? She said it's something about the way your girl just makes her feel. Whatever you been dreaming about, I swear to make it real. Just run around the town with me, then come lay down.
I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the shit that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, well, yeah, girls want girls where, yeah, girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, hey, girls want girls where, hey, well, girls want girls where I'm from. But I know you wanna roll with the gang, and I know you want the finest of things. Asking me about settling down, cause you know that things are going my way.
And you're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 4 song, Drake featuring Lil Baby, Girls Want Girls. And moving right along to our number 3 song, here is Doja Cat and The Weeknd, You Right.
Give me the hip hop countdown.
Yeah. Number 3.
You're right, I got my guy, but I
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 3 song, Doja Cat and The Weeknd. You right. Stevie J, he wants spousal support from Faith Evans. He wants her to pay his legal fees and be not have to pay spousal support. As a matter of fact, he wants spousal support from her. Now, originally when I read this, this looked kind of crazy to me, but how is it different? How is it different than what a lot of women do to men these days? These days and for the past years, they get spousal support during divorces. They get taken care of during divorces when the guy makes more. So how is he wrong? We got to be fair about this, right? We got to be fair about the situation. If women can do it, why can't men do it? If women can be taken care of, why can't men be taken care of when the woman makes more? I don't know. I just think we got to be fair about it. Now, it sounded crazy at first because that's what we are conditioned to think and believe, that, oh, he a guy, he shouldn't be asking for spousal support. But why not? Why not? What's wrong with it? What's he doing wrong? I think he's doing what he should do as far as making sure that he's taken care of, because he was used to a certain lifestyle that she provided. And even though they weren't married long, it's the same thing. This reverse situation has been happening for years where women do the same thing to men. So it's only fair. We got to be fair about it, right? So I don't think he's wrong. That's just my opinion. Master P wants to be declared single as well. Him and his ex-wife, his wife separated over a decade ago. He wants to be able to start over again. They filed for divorce. I don't know who filed for divorce. I think it was him. He filed for divorce back in 2013. And after they separated in 2010, they settled everything in 2016. But they claimed that the paperwork wasn't filed with the court, so they were never legally divorced. So he just wants the judge to legally declare him single. And I think that's fair. After being separated for this long and doing the necessary steps, I think that's the right call and the right thing to do. So, you know, good luck to him. I hope the judges give it to him. You know, there's no mess, no fuss, none of that. So, Master P want to be single, go be single. Dame Dash was on Bootleg Kev's show. He talked about some of the words that he invented, sayings he invented like pause and other phrases and things that he came up with. So here's what he had to say as far as all of that goes.
If it's coming, why fear it? Embrace it.
Pause.
Monetize.
Oh, God, that was crazy.
Big pause.
Big pause.
Did you invent pause?
Yes. My crew, the best out, we invented pause for sure. There's nobody could ever say that I didn't. No, that's all of us. That came from my block. It's not meant to be offensive. It's always been a personal joke with my friends. And now the whole world does it. It's like, I can't even have a personal joke.
And now everyone says
literally
pause.
People would ask me, I'd be like, I would never tell them what it meant, ever. I'd be like, you have to figure it out. Pop tags, I made that one up.
Okay,
I'm the one that named Hova. I made that up.
What was this, the inspiration for
I
the
did
Hova?
That too. It's Jehovah. It was, yeah, like, you know.
So when y'all out here saying certain things and saying phrases, know your history, know where it came from. Salute out to Dame Dash. Always been a fan of Dame Dash. A huge fan. For those who don't know, I don't know how you don't know, but Dame Dash and Jay-Z were, along with Biggs, were a part of Rockefeller and creating that whole Rockefeller movement in the 2000s, early 2010s. You know, that was a big part of my first few years in the military, and actually before I even went to the military, Rockefeller. So huge fan of Dame Dash. Jussie Smollett took the stand. He's still testifying. Well, his case is still going on. As for those who don't know, he is charged with staging a fake robbery. I guess saying that he was robbed when he wasn't. Filing a false police report. He's facing 3 years in prison for that. So he was on the stand today, took the stand. He was there for over 5 hours, on the stand for over 5 hours. Of course, he denies staging the attack. He says the brothers that attacked him may have had other motives. He claims that one of the brothers helped him get drugs, cocaine specifically, and says that they had a sexual relationship. He also claims he never told the police that the attackers were wearing MAGA hats. So I guess according to his story, the police made up the whole MAGA hat thing, and he says he never said that, that they said that, which I don't know why police would make up that part of a suspected victim's statement. I have taken many statements as a police officer when I was in the military, and not one time was I had the desire to add stuff in or make something up. And to make up something as specific as they were wearing MAGA hats, why would they do? You know what? I'm not even going to that part. I don't believe them. I don't believe them. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of Jussie Smollett. I'm not a fan. I don't believe him. I don't believe anything he says. I don't believe he doesn't seem like a genuine person. He seems like he does stuff and says things for attention. He seems like a classic narcissist, and I'm not a fan. I am not a fan of him or his. And I used to be. I got on the Empire train late. And when I say late, I mean like I started watching like season 2. Season 2 was when I started watching, because I was into Power at first. And I was like, ain't nothing better than Power. I was all about the Power train. I still am. Power is one of the best shows that was ever made. But anyway, I started watching Empire, and I liked it. I liked the show. I liked Power. I liked him. I liked his character. I liked the whole dynamic of everything. But when he started doing stuff like this and, you know, trying to boost his fame is what I feel he was trying to do. And it went wrong, and he got caught. And now he's trying to backtrack and blame everybody else. I don't like that. I don't like that. It doesn't seem like something a genuine person, someone who's a genuine person, would do. And I don't like him. I don't like how he operates. I don't like how he moves. I don't like how he tries to play a victim at every turn. And I don't like how he tries to weaponize his blackness. I don't like how he tries to weaponize his sexuality. I don't like any of that, because people are really going through that stuff. This stuff that he's claiming is really happening to people, and he's using it to boost his fame. And I don't like that. I don't like when people do that. I just don't like it. So, but he was back on the stand today. I don't know what was said today, but as soon as I find out, I will let you know, because I'm sure there'll be more to this. But I don't believe him. I don't believe anything he says, because he doesn't seem like he's a person who tells the truth. He doesn't seem like a person who is genuine, and I'm not a fan. I don't like him. But anyway, that's not why we're here. We're not here to talk about people I don't like. We're here to talk about stuff that we all like, and that's this music. So let's get into this number 2 song. Here is Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More, here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip hop countdown.
Yo. Number 2.
Baby, hold me. after that you lost without me. All my feel like I dodged the county. You feel like jail. I can't even exhale. Like Holy Grail, you know that. You gon' make me need bail, you know that. Caught tripping with your friend. You ain't even had me lying on your. You know that. Got me a bag for the break, you know that. Control on shoulder, pace and fight, throw back. All this for real.
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 2 song, Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More. Now, before I get into that number 1 song, as always, let me take a second to thank some of our sponsors.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
So, who's trying to spend 12 hours in a salon? Not me, and not you either. Nobody wants to spend their whole day like that. Yo, pull up and get slayed by the V. I'm trying to put you on. Vanquish Beauty Studio is the move. 2130 Wards Road in Lynchburg. They provide confidence and sass, so it accommodates the swag you already have. Their talented artists specialize in color, cut, healthy, and diverse textures of hair. They're a 3-time award-winning salon right in Lynchburg. Vanquish Beauty Studio. They'll turn your hair ideas into a reality without spending the whole day in the salon. So book your appointment now. Go online to vanquishbeautystudio.com or call 434-239-HAIR. That's 434-239-4247. Experience a professional salon, impeccable style, ambiance, and sophistication all in one place. Vanquish Beauty Studio. Pull up and get slayed by the V.
How do you make financial decisions? Are you retiring soon or wondering how much life insurance is enough? Your family and financial future is the most important thing, and having answers to these questions are mandatory. Bold Financial Strategies is a successful financial team that can help you answer these questions while achieving your goals. Bold Financial Strategies offers a suite of services that range from retirement plans and college savings to homeowners insurance policies, as well as estate planning and life insurance protection. We pride ourselves on making the process simple and understandable for all of our clients. Take control of your financial future and visit our website at boldfinancialstrategies.com or give us a call at 434-215-0695. The team of advisors includes owner Damon Bolden, Garnett Spanky McDaniel, Randy Calloway, and Devin Bowling. We are located at 3712 Old Forest Road, Suite 400, Lynchburg, Virginia. Oh, and we also make ourselves available for online and virtual appointments. Bold Financial Strategies. We help all of our clients plan and make smarter financial decisions, and we would love to start with yours.
The Mix 88.9 presents December to Remember, a Candy Cane Cabaret. Saturday, December 18th at Boonesboro Ruitton Club, 1499 Coffee Road in Lynchburg.
It's that time of year again.
Christmas.
Come party with us holiday style.
Let's go.
Music provided by the Mix 88.9's own DJs, Chaos the Connoisseur, DJ Cool V, and DJ Kid New, the talk of New York.
Oh!
Get your advance tickets at themixradio.online. By phone, 434-300-8940. Where part of the proceeds will go to support Virginia Prep Sports Academy. December to Remember, a Candy Cane Cabaret. Saturday, December 18th at Boonesboro Ruitton Club in Lynchburg. Doors open at 9. This cabaret is BYOB. Brought to you by The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's #1 station for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae.
It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's #1 station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Give me the hip-hop.
Countdown.
Yeah. This is the #1 song.
#1.
Yeah. DJ gon' play it.
Too sexy for this girl, too sexy for
your girl. Too sexy for this world. Too sexy for this ice. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain. Too sexy for your game. Too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap. Too sexy for that cap. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, alright, that's fine. Okay, okay. I'm feeling too sexy to accept requests.
Way too sexy.
And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected.
Way too sexy.
And she popped a Tesla, now she gonna let you. Okay, alright, that's fine. Okay, think we got too sexy for that metro housing.
Way too sexy.
Diamond popped out, almost swallowed 60,000.
60 pieces.
Section need more things in here, I like it crowded.
Hey, whoa, whoa.
Yeah, I like it crowded. Oh, you like the boy? Well, tell me what you like about him. You a turnt, a little thotty, ain't no wife about it. I'ma f*** friends and send her back to metro housing.
Yeah. I'm too sexy for this sir. Too sexy for your girl. Too sexy for this world. Too sexy for this ice. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain. Too sexy for your game. Too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap. Too sexy for that cap. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. Pop out, get ghosts on the you don't know where I went. Pray for all my dogs, all my behind the fence. Dripping in and out, spilling in a new designer gear by a coaster. Pay attention to the detail, going two-tone on choker. Young always ready to murk, some call them some smokers. Young but most you don't make sure the car get did a 360 windmill when I left the scene. That's that action, her best work on her knees. Too sexy for this cash, too sexy for this serve. Too sexy for these pills, I'm too sexy for this. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Money, cars, and all the jewelry, make a sexy. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Yeah, wow, wow. I'm too sexy for this serve. Too sexy for your girl. Too sexy for this world. Too sexy for this ice. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain. Too sexy for your game. Too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap. Too sexy for that cap. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah.
Too sexy to count. Fitty, my neck, Bugatti, red diamond, spaghetti. This paper, I shred it, I swindle, no sweating. I saw you begging, goddamn you pity. I ain't done spinning, no pin pinch, I spin it. Bags in that, my man ain't gon' steal it. 100 bags for maybe young, wish they was rich. A Green Gators, they look like a switch. Giorgio, I spit 26 licks. Too sexy, my neck, Bugatti. Caress me, I'll let you today ski. I've been kicking, might need a prosthetic. I pray to the chopper under my pillow, to fairy.
And you're listening to the Mix at 6 here on the Mix 88.9. That was our number one song, Drake featuring Future and Young Thug, Way Too Sexy. Well, now's the part of the show where I get to give you your flowers, where I get to say thank you. I get to say I appreciate you for hanging out with me for this last hour. It's fun as always. I'm up here just living the dream. Hopefully I'm entertaining and entertaining you. And if you enjoyed yourself, please let someone else know. Let someone else know to download the app so they can join me Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern, because that's important. Let them know to go to their Google Play Apple App Store, download the app, search the Mix 88.9 so they can have the fun that you had today. Also, they can follow us on social media. Facebook, Instagram, The Mix 88.9, and on Twitter, The Mix 8991. You can also stream us online, TheMixRadio.com. mixradio.online. That's the Mix Radio. That's all one word, .online. And you can hear me streaming over there right now because we're all here on the app and streaming 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We got old school. We got new school. We got reggae. We got inspirational. We got sports talk. We got it all. We got you covered, but you got to download the app and it's free. And if you've liked me, if you've enjoyed what I do, if you've enjoyed what I've been doing, you can follow me also. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Discord. I'm on everything. Everything at Kalel Creed DB. That's K-A-L-E-L C-R-E-E-D D-B. That's Kalel Creed DB. If you've missed any part of this show, and you want to catch up on this show and possibly past episodes, just go over and click them and just let them all play. Go over to my YouTube page, The Fortress of Awesome Dude. That's AweSomeTude. That's The Fortress of Awesome Dude. Go to the playlist, look for Vibe Club, click that Vibe Club playlist, and they are all there for you and your enjoyment. You can also just hang out there. Just look at all the videos that I have because I'm highly entertaining, I think, anyway. I got gaming videos. I got comedy skit videos. I got everything. Anything that I do that I feel like I can be creative and express, I do that. And I put it over there. And I put it over there for you for free. Click that subscribe button. Click that bell so you're notified when I upload, which is pretty much every day. But that's going to do it for me today. You don't have anywhere to go. You don't have to touch that phone. You don't have to touch that computer. You don't have to touch whatever you are listening to my voice flow through your speakers from. Because DJ Kid New in the Recovery Room is coming up right after me. He got you covered for the next hour. That's right, for another hour. You don't have anything to do. No decisions to make. Just relax and chill. But that's going to do it for me here today. Thank you for joining me. I will see you all here tomorrow, same time.